Good morning, students. Today we'll do History Standard 6. Topic is Question and Answers of Chapter 2. Today we are going to discuss, and you are going to write down all the question answers in your notebooks, history notebooks. In this slide, you can see, children, 4-5 slides I have given the pages of your book, in which I have marked some important points that you can go through, and you can just search for your answers, and you can copy it down in your own words also, but grammatically do take care of that, and you can also follow whatever I have marked, and you can note it down in your classwork copies. In this slide, children, you all see fill in the blanks are given over here in page number 21 of your book. So you need to solve them. I hope you all have solved. Just check when I say the answers. The history of ancient Egypt is divided into how many periods? They are divided into 3 periods. Then who were at the bottom of Egyptian society? Slaves. Then which queen ruled with her husband Akhenaten? That is Nefertiti. And remember, N will be in capital. You are writing the name of a queen. Then dash, which was a major occupation? Agriculture. Then which thing was carved out into a single block from us, or out of a single block of stone? That is Sphinx. I have also shown you the statue of that. And then Egyptian followed which calendar? Solar calendar. Come to the B part, see, circle the correct answer. The Egyptian king was called Pharaoh. Then the two popular forms of amusement were singing and what? Dancing was there. Chief god of Egyptian, Amun-Re. Then oil was major item of export. Egyptian used the knowledge of astrology or mathematics. It will be mathematics to construct pyramids, because they are talking about the pyramids. Number 6 will be sheets of paper. They were made from what? Papyrus. I have already explained it. It's papyrus, not papyrus. So, okay, the pronunciation is papyrus. So papyrus sheets. Now we'll in number C we'll see the clues, and then we'll write the names. So the tribe that invaded ancient Egypt in number 1 is Hyksos. Number 2, the political and religious leaders of Egypt will be Pharaoh. Which is the popular board game? That is Sinet. 4th is the god of mummification, which is known as Anubis. And one of the 7 wonders, the Great Pyramid at Giza. The Egyptian system of writing, hieroglyphics. Now come to the D part, where give reasons for the following is written. There, most Egyptians were engaged in agriculture, that you have to give reason. How do we come to know? So you have to write, because the soil, the most Egyptians were engaged in agriculture because the fertile soil, then you have to give a comma, and then you have to follow page number 18 where it is written fertile soil, regular supply of water from the Nile and vast irrigation network meant that farmers could grow crops throughout the year. So this we can also understand, and we can also see in page number 16, from there very first paragraph also you can get some points if you read. So go through that also, you can add some part if you like from there. Then number D2, you see the Egyptian preserved their dead. Why they did that? They did because according to them, death is a temporary phase between life and the next, that you have to write. Now coming to the E part, that is answer these questions. Number 1, what has helped us to reconstruct the history of Egypt? It will be archaeological excavations, and it is also given in page number 16. We can see from there you have to write E1. I have mentioned over there E1 means answer this question, that E is written and 1 is number 1. So, archaeological excavations, inscription and official document. These all things have helped us to reconstruct the history of past. This is only how we have come to know. Okay, number 2, describe the social classes that emerged in ancient Egypt. It will be in page number 16 you find. We have to write about the social classes where I have written E2 and I have put brackets also. The ruler was called the Pharaoh and was treated as God. Then the Pharaoh took all major decisions concerning the empire. Then next came priest and then the nobles, official and scribes, followed by merchant, artisans and farmers. At the lowest rung were the slaves, most of whom were prisoners of war. That you need to write. Then number 3, write about the condition of women in ancient Egypt. You have to see page number 17. So you have to write from there about the condition of women in ancient Egypt. That is E3 where I have written, you can see women belonging to life of the people, that part. Women belonging to poor families worked on fields and looked after their house. Rich women led better lives. Many of them could read and write. So we can also give the example of some powerful queens, that is, for example, Queen Hatshepsut. Okay. Then the next comes question number 4, name some of the gods that people worshipped in ancient Egypt. That you will get in page number 18, where you can see I have put the brackets over there in the religion part. So from there you can write that part. The chief god was Imenri or Ra, the sun god. Then you have to also write that it was considered the source of warmth and life. Other gods that were worshipped were Thor, the moon god, which was represented by Abyss, a water bird. Horus, the sky god, represented by a hawk. Anubis, the god of mummification, was represented by a jackal. That part you need to mention and write it in your own words, children. Try to write. I know there must be grammatical mistakes, but don't worry about that. You just write it down, because as soon as the school reopens, your copies will be taken up for correction. How did the Egyptians preserve their dead? That part you need to write, the Egyptians, and then you have to follow page number 18. You can see over there I have written E5, and there you need to see preserve their dead by mummifying their bodies. They covered the dead body with herbs and spices and then wrapped it in a fine linen, such a preserved body is called a mummy. Then you have to write number 6, discuss the architectural achievements of the Egyptians. That you need to follow page number 19, where you can see major achievement in architecture. There you can see E6 I have written, that is page number 19. From there you can write Egyptians were great builders. They constructed many pyramids and temples. And somewhere like Great Pyramid at Giza, which was built by Pharaoh Cheops. And it was also called one of the 7 wonders in ancient world. Another architectural wonder was Sphinx, which I showed. It is a mythological figure with the head of a man and the body of a lion. Then a little bit description about the temple at Abu Simbel, which was built by Ramesses II. And that you can write down about the back of the interior temple, that is, the rays of the sun reached there. That part you can mention. And the last is discuss the progress made by Egyptian in astronomy, which is given in page number 20. You can see the astronomy part marked. So the part which is marked, you can take points, some important points, and you can jot it down in that answer. So all the answers you need to write, question plus answers you need to write in your history copy. So this is a picture study which we have to do. It is a scene from the tomb of an artisan. It is taken. So we can see what he is doing. He is a kind of farmer. So, we have to discuss the life of poor in ancient Egypt, which is given in page number 17 of your book. You can see I have marked with F1. That part you need to go through and write down. The poor worked as servants or laborers in rich households. Their houses were very small. They had only one room, consisting of one room. And the poor wore jewelry made of cheap metals. That you need to write in this part. And the second part, write a short note on the occupation in ancient Egypt. That you have to go to page number 18. And from there, occupation part, you can see over there. In this part, you need to write from there. Occupation, you just go through. And from there, you can write down that most people were engaged in agriculture. And then pottery making, spinning, weaving, from there you can give carpentry was there. Then pottery was produced in large quantities. The metal workers made articles of gold, copper and metals. These parts, whatever I have explained you in the class, that part you can merge and write in your own words. So this picture study also, children, here is no space because the answers are little lengthy. So you cannot write it over here. So better you write it down in your notebooks itself. In this slide, children, you'll see the gold coffin of Tutankhamun. He was actually a pharaoh, a king, and archaeologists have found articles of daily use. Who are archaeologists? So the ones who find whatever the materials are left in past, they dig it out or they try to find out from when it was there lying and everything related to the past history. So they have found that articles of everyday use, whatever they used to use every day, these pharaohs, this king, such as beds, chests are like drawers and all, that were found in Tutankhamun's tomb.